In the inquiry into audit queries of Kampala Capital City Authority for the financial year 2021-2022, the House Committee of Commission's Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises COSASE established that several acting directors in Kampala Capital City Authority were illegally recruited into offices.
Director, Deputy Director, Acting Director, Acting Deputy Director. Those appointments can only be made by the Service Commission. True or false?
It is true.
True. So one would mean that would mean that anyone who occupies any of those four positions, Director, Deputy Director, Acting Director, Acting Deputy Director, that anyone who occupies those positions and acts.
The committee, chaired by Nakawa East legislator Joel Senyonyi, found out today that several directors in KCCA who have been serving in acting capacity were appointed by KCCA top management instead of the Public Service Commission, as according to public service standing orders. These include the acting director legal and litigation affairs, Caleb Mucha, who has been serving as an acting director legal affairs for over 2 years until recently in January when he was fully appointed.
Appointed themselves to those positions without any legal instrument, and therefore to me, that's illegal. Although now they have been confirmed in those positions, but the first place they were put there illegally. They were supposed to go through public service. They were supposed to go through either the president appointing them for them. The ED just appointed them in those positions in acting capacity against the law.
Acting appointment. This occurs when temporary assignment of an employee to the duties of a higher position is made by the appointing authority. Now, this brings you into picture who can actually put you in acting capacity. It must be the appointing authority. The employee is paid acting allowance. The acting appointment is for a period not for not more than 6 months. And at a time, and is renewable once. By presumption, it can only go to a year.
The instrument of assigning Mr. Caleb the assignment of duty, and which was signed on 10th of January of this year.
Signed by
the latest by the executive director, Madam Dorothy.
And when was he substantively appointed deputy director? Because you told us January.
Yes, they accepted the position of Deputy Director Litigation in January.
The committee is concerned that his illegal appointment has adverse effects on the legality of contracts which he has signed on behalf of KCCA, which puts taxpayers' money at risk.
The documents, for example, that Caleb could have signed as acting director, legally, what consequence does that have when he represents the authority in that capacity, and yet it is not the appropriate body that appointed him that position?
But in the circumstance that these positions are not filled for the last so many years, what probably would we have done as an entity in order to run the organization for all this time until it was filled substantively?
Legislators also oppose the fact that these acting directors have been remunerated as directors, which according to them is illegal since their appointment was irregular.
The acting cannot be done by internal mechanism. How do you now decide that on the payment you can pay the person in acting capacity, yet the acting capacity can only be affected by the Public Service Commission?
The practice to assign and assign does not attract the difference in the salaries. But when it comes to appointing acting, it is associated with an instrument. This is what the members want to know. Were you paying those people assigned 1 week, 2 weeks?
However, the Director of Human Resource in KCCA, Grace Akulo, told COSASE that the officers in question were never appointed to the said positions, but they were only assigned duties under those positions.
Recruitment or reassignment of roles and functions are done, and even if you look into the standing orders, it is equally implied in there.
KCCA has been given extra time to furnish the committee with more information concerning the irregular appointments.
More problematic
you find somebody is entering contracts on behalf of the entity as a director, and yet the appointment later is manager. Somebody can actually go to court and challenge some of these contracts and all of that, and we end up losing a lot of money, a lot more than what we have lost in terms of salaries, that somebody's supposed to be earning salary A, but they're earning salary B because of an appointment that was outside the law.
The Senyonyi-led committee also spared time off audit queries to question KCCA on the rampant spate of floods in Kampala, which wreak havoc whenever Kampala experiences heavy downpours. Legislators wondered that even newly commissioned roads like Acacia Avenue are flooding, as if drainage systems were not addressed during construction.
Understand why is the situation this way, and what is KCCA doing about it? Because you see, when I see, now look at that fairway area, light area and so on. This is a newly constructed project. But whenever it rains, that whole place floods. Cars get submerged. I'm trying to understand why and what's being done to remedy that. Because sometimes we get excited when we see new traffic lights, roundabout and all of that. Is it that we are not catering for drainage? Is it what exactly?
CA has to work on this thing, but our appeal is to call upon Parliament to assist us also and the whole of Uganda to deal with this issue of the capital city. It's being wasted by the citizens themselves.
Report by Fred Kajibi for the news.